This performance, we have five amazing artists that are going to come up here. They'll already be judged. But in addition to the finalists that we have, we also have three amazing judges in the room tonight. We have Mr. Mig. Tell us who you are. We got Bob Schwartz. We got Mr. Bernie Resnick. They're in the house tonight. They're going to be judging the artists for the finalists. Tonight, I also want to introduce myself. My name is Brian Cronin. I'm a dad, music fan. I'm here, your host for the evening. But without you, I want to introduce to you the man in charge, Councilman.
Thank you very much, Brian, and all the judges. So, just for people who might not know what this is, what this is actually, it's a music group for them. What it's really about is the fact that people who have talent and determination and aspirations really need a platform. And if there is no platform in Philadelphia, either they don't rise up or they go someplace else, right? And that's not a good thing for our city. We want to be a city where people can really be the person they want to be right here in our city. It is, however, unfortunately, a struggle. I think it's a bigger struggle than it should be. And I say that because sometimes people say to me, like, why are you doing this music thing and you create a large economy? And I tell them, listen, because our city truly needs it. And it is such an economic engine that it's a very large lift in it. Before the pandemic, our city was doing, on an annual basis, $3.4 billion a year in economic impact. Household income was $920 million a year. That's a lot of people make a lot of money. And local taxes was $157 million. You can talk about edge and edge, but you've got to talk about arts and culture. But beyond that, it is applicable to so many people. So many people who have experienced both good and bad, and hardships, and great successes, great failures. They put it in lyrics, they put it in song, they bring their creativity, and they put it out. You know, they put it all on the line and they hear that, right? It's not something everybody can do. And as a talentless person, I have to admire that, right? And I think that's one of the things. We should be a city that really cheers on other people. We should be admirers of others. We should really want to see people succeed. One of our biggest problems in this city right now is that we have a lot of young people that at their young age, that just feel hopeless. A light at the end of the tunnel, and you know what happens? They become very, very negative, and they unfortunately become very violent. We have to really turn that around. And so, if we could do this as a city, and I appreciate Dunkin' Donuts. Let me shout out Dunkin' Donuts, Laborers 57, because they're providing the prizes. But if our city would put its money and resources and all of its organization behind it, it would be just so much better. Let me congratulate the five finalists. Give yourselves a round of applause, because you are the winners, right? Everyone who submitted is a winner, but the five finalists. What happens is judges look at all the videos, they come up with five finalists, and now you're here to perform live. And part of that is just the continuation, looking at the video, now you come here, because this is about your success in the music industry, your ability to translate your talent and everything into something that will push you up higher, deliver, I hope, what you want, but also provide other people with jobs and opportunities. Finally, don't forget about, and they'll remind you, Brian will, People's Choice. We have 10 music categories, and we have three fantastic judges, and they're gonna score. And then what happens is we're gonna announce the winner December the 20th downstairs. What happens then is there's a people's choice, right? These are the judges, and there's prizes for the winner of each one of the 10 categories. But people's choice, what is that about? That's about you, your marketing, your hustle, your ability to get out there, get your fans, get people together to vote for you. You don't want to be a tree falling in the forest that nobody sees. You've got to really push it. And if you do that, there is another $1,000 and some other prizes. Well, with all of that, I wish you all good luck, and I hope to, you know, have a great performance tonight, which I'm sure we shall see. And then, the most important thing, I'll say this. You're not really here to win PHL Live. You're here to present yourself, to network, and even if you weren't selected, if you weren't selected as a finalist, come by. Come to the shows. There might be one out of three judges that just thinks you're the best, but you didn't make the cut with the other two. But that judge would love to see you, and they would love to support you. Our judges are really doing this because they want to support the music industry, and your opportunity to really get them to get behind you and share their knowledge, their networks, they just don't do it for anybody, I'll be honest. You know, I've known these guys, I've worked with them for like 7 years now. But when they want to get behind you, they do. They are very, very low key. I'm always like, I feel like we don't do them justice. They're very low key because they're not trying to attract any attention to themselves, I figure. I could name drop all day long. I know some of the things that they do. Meet them, greet them, talk with them, seek their help. They're happy to help, and yeah, if you connect, I hope that they will help you succeed where you want to succeed. All right, thank you very much.
Nixtreme.com, because he's going to be, as we're talking right now, he's broadcasting live on the internet. So without further ado, I want to bring out our first finalist, if I can bring up Camille K. So I just want to ask you, Camille, how did you find out about PHL Live?
So I actually just saw an ad on it online, and I thought it was really interesting, and I just really wanted to be a part of it. So, you know, I signed up and everything, and I'm so, so happy to be here.
That's awesome. And what I want to say, and how people out here who's going to hear you for the first time, how do they find your music?
You can find me on Instagram, Facebook, and I'm on all streaming platforms. You just search up Camille K Music, and that's where you can find me on everything.
Well, let Camille perform. Big round of applause for Camille K.
Hey, so I'm Camille K. I'm 16 years old, and I'm a singer-songwriter and musician from the Philly area. And tonight I'm going to be playing some of my originals, and this first one is called Still in Love, and it's about still being in love with someone even after heartbreak. So I hope you enjoy this. Bye. so much, everyone. That was my song called Still in Love, and it's out now on all streaming platforms. And this next song that I have is actually an unreleased original that should be coming out pretty soon on December 9th. This one is called How Can I Ever Love Again?
Thank you.
much. That's my new song called How Can I Ever Love Again. And this last one is another unreleased original. This one's called Daydream.
Thank you.
Let me just say that was amazing. Camille, being that you said you're only 16, I have to ask one question.
Sure.
Being the music you write, these are your original songs, very hard, strong. So what was the age you were when you started writing songs?
I think I wrote my first song, like, seriously, when I was around 12 years old.
Oh, wow. You have such an old soul, you great song. Give it up.
Thank you very much.
Guys, I just want to let everybody know, when we're doing this, when the judges are out there doing their judging, the things that they're all being judged on, so if you guys have an idea, they're being judged on overall musicianship and their skill, their stage presence, obviously that's important, as well as their originality, songwriting ability, their lyrics, and crowd reaction and participation. Having crowd reaction and participation really helps bring it up. So you guys, every time there's an artist up here, if you're into them, really show your participation, so that actually boosts everyone's judging up. So just so you know. At this point, I want to also recognize our sponsors. We have, obviously, Office of Councilman David O, Duncan, Laborers Local Union 57, Medico Unidos LLC, and Start CDL. So thanks to those sponsors to put this on for us. I want to talk, you know, Councilman O talked to you a little bit about the People's Choice Awards and how important it is. If you got like somebody you want to vote for yourself, being in the audience, all you have to do is go to phllive.org and vote for the person that you like. Because we want you to be proactive, more importantly nowadays, in addition to the judging that's going on. So it's all about you, the listeners of the music. So please go to phllive.org and put in your People's Choice Award. Just to give you an idea, some of the prizes they're going to be winning. Each of the 11, there's 11 winners, as Councilman was talking to you about, the 10 different genres of music, plus the People's Choice Award. Each winner will receive $1,000 in cash, as well as some studio time, City Council Citation Award, which is awarded to each person, which is a really big deal. They're going to be presenting a lot of this stuff at the award show on December 20th downstairs. There's a resolution to the group of all 11 winners. So December 20th, you should also mark that calendar, come out and see who wins. At this point, we're going to do a changeover. Are we moving any of the equipment, or we're moving on? Okay. I didn't know if there's any like new instruments coming out. I do want to introduce our next finalist. Finalist number two, we have Kyper. Woo! Come on up, Kyper. Well,
did. Yes, you did. Listen, I walked by you and I'm like,
Cronin has a lot to learn. our song because we haven't released yet and we don't have a name for it. One more song? I'll take that as a yes.
Yes.
For somebody who just lost her voice 10 minutes before, I mean, come on. It's great. What do you guys think? So tell us a little bit about yourselves. Introduce yourselves, if you can.
So I'm Jess.
I'm Kayla.
So my question is, you guys have been doing this for a while. You said over 2 years together now, writing songs?
Yeah, we started making music together during COVID, and then I guess really only started like promoting ourselves hardcore within the past kind of year or so. So, yeah.
So in the last year, so let us know, what is the rush you get when you're up on the stage and you're looking at everyone looking at you, listening to what you actually put together?
It's kind of exhilarating hearing people clap for something that you wrote in like your dorm room like 3 years ago. It's pretty great.
For sure, I bet it was noticeable when I lost the nerves, because you know the dopamine takes over. It's my favorite thing in the world. It's my passion, and I will spend my life on a stage or die trying. And
that's the answer we want to hear. Let's give it up for Kyper, everybody.
Thank you.
Well, while these guys are changing over, I want the audience to meet some of the judges, so you know who the judges are, what they do, and why they're here. So, fun fact, the person I'm going to introduce you to, when I was a little boy, which was like last year, my actual professor is in the house tonight, and I'm honored to have him come up here. Mr. Bernie Resnick, come on up. Hey, can we put that mic on? Sorry.
Hi, everybody. How are you? First of all, I just want to say we should all send nice thoughts to one of the great pop songwriters in history who passed away this morning, Christine McVie from Fleetwood Mac, passed away. She wrote so many great songs. Say That You Love Me, Everywhere, which is, I think, a Buick commercial now, 40 years later. Don't Stop Thinking About Tomorrow, which she was smart enough to know that the other guy in the band, Lindsay, ought to sing lead on. But think about that song, very positive message. All lyrics are very, you know, uplifting lyrics, and it's every chord is a major chord. And there's no wonder that Bill Clinton chose that to be the theme song for his reelection campaign in 1992. So all of the people who are here tonight should study Christine McVie and learn what great pop songwriting craft is really about. One of the wonderful things about this competition is that we as judges get to hear all this amazing new talent. And I just did the classical music competition judging a few weeks ago, which is very different than tonight, but also really cool. Some amazingly talented people around here. And for those of you who are in the audience that are not participants, but that are fans or family, thank you. Thank you for supporting these artists, because it means so much to people who are on the stage to know that they have friends and family out there in the audience cheering for them. And for those who are competing, think about music is supposed to be collaborative, not competitive. And so it's difficult to come into a situation like this to think about competing. But I tell people, don't do that. Just entertain people, do what you do, have a good time, be passionate about your music, and don't worry about it. Winning or losing, it's not about that. It's about making new fans, meeting new people, and having a good time while you're doing it. So I encourage everyone to root on those who are your hero support, and also keep your ears open to hear something new that's really cool. And for those who are participating, you might hear somebody you might want to work with and collaborate with them. You never know. So enjoy everybody tonight, and great to see you all.
But before you leave, you should tell everybody who you are and what you do.
I'm a musician who went to law school, so I'm an entertainment lawyer, and I represent talented people of all walks of life and all sizes and shapes and in all different styles of entertainment. And my job is to guide people through the dangerous world that is the entertainment business and let them reach the shore with their wallet intact, the shark-filled waters. So that's sort of what I do.
Thank you. Thank you, Bernie. this moment, I just want to recognize the participating venues that's been involved with PHL Live this year. We have the Philadelphia Folk Song Society. We have Sweeney's Saloon. We have the Clef Club of Jazz, City Winery, Settlement Music School, and of course, World Cafe Live. Like, we're at World Cafe Live, so let's give it up to our bartender and servers. Make sure to take care of them tonight. And I'm going to come back and I'm going to introduce the next act that's coming up. So if you want to do the changeover, come on up, and then I will announce who they are. Okay.
Thank you.
Whoa, hey. You guys having a good time, right? I hope you guys are having a good time. All I want to do at this moment, so back in 2019, I was asked to come out and MC the pop event we did. Ooh, I guess I can't remember the name of the venue, but it doesn't really matter. The point of the story is I saw these guys perform then. I was blown away. I thought they were great. I'm excited to introduce them tonight. So let's give a warm welcome to Dom and Jesse.
Oh, what's going on, World Cafe Live?
Check, check.
How you feeling out there?
Yeah.
Oh, no, come on, we can do way better than that. How y'all feeling?
Yeah. All right, if you're here to support some other artists tonight, make some noise. There you go. I just wanted to see if you guys are making noise at all.
Jesse, I think there's a little empty space right here, bro. So what we're going to need right from the very start is as many people as possible to just come on up front. Let's have a good time.
Don't be shy. Come
we
on,
have
y'all.
A saying called summer Let's all go. Year. This Let's is go. Our phrase. Because no matter where we are, we bring the sunshine. So we need the sunshine right in front of us. Come on.
Especially
Everybody
if you're here
possible.
To see us.
Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on.
Especially if you're here to see Dom and Jess, if you want to see you guys up front. Let's make it good vibes here. All right. This first song of ours is called See the Stars. Let's get it.
Get through this part, if we get through this part, we were meant to be together, find our way out of the dark. If we get through this part, if we get through this part, we gon' make it to forever. I promise we gon' see the stars. We built this thing, tripping far apart, can't fix it. Still it goes too far from the feeling that we had when we started. Start the fire, keep it alive. Hey. Now I know it's getting dark now, we just need a spark now. Maybe it'll show us the way.
Let's go, come on.
Maybe a little way out, if you come with me right now, we can turn the night into day.
Are you with me?
If we get through this part,
let's go.
If we get through this part, we gon' make it to forever. I promise we gon' see the stars.
Let's have a good time tonight. We can have it live.
Promise we gon' see the stars.
Yeah. Oh, oh. Come on, Jesse, give it to him, bro. Come on. Hey,
on a mission to ignite our hearts in the mission. Good night, our hearts to the feeling that we had when we started. We just gotta keep it alive. Now I know it's getting
dark. Let's see some claps out there.
We just need a spark now. Maybe you'll show us the way.
You guys can clap too. Come on.
Trust
y'all.
Me, there's a way out. If you come with me right now, we can turn the night into.
Are you with me?
If we get through this part, if we get through this part, we gon' make it to forever. I promise we gon' see the stars. I promise we gon' see the stars. I promise we gon' see the stars.
Let's go.
If we get through this part, if we get through this part, we gon' make it to forever. I promise we gon' see the stars.
Make some noise if you're having a good time so far. World Cafe Live.
Man. So once again, we are Dom and Jesse. You can follow us everywhere at Dom and Jesse. DomAndJessC. And as you can just tell by now, we bring summer everywhere we are.
That's right.
Wait, what do we say?
We say summer all year.
What do we say?
Summer all year.
That's what I'm talking about.
That means good vibes all year, ladies and gentlemen.
So everybody, this is Jesse Lopez here.
Hello.
He's got a little hidden talent of his that he's about to show you. We've got another original. And instead of doing a track to it, he's going to recreate this doing a beatbox and a loop pedal.
And we're just going to jam out for a little bit if you guys are cool with that.
This one's called No Hero. You don't need superpowers to be there for the ones you love. So that's what this next song is about. Once again, can we get some claps? Can you guys help us out with some claps? Hey, you sound great out there. Goes like this.
I won't always get this right with no excuses. If I ever make you cry, I apologize. Any time gives us a chance and I can prove it. We may fight and we may argue, but I can compromise. I can listen, not be humble, I can learn from you. You can trust me, I've been loyal, I won't change.
I won't change.
You're my reason, you're my passion, you inspire me. I'll always be the one that you can count on, the one you know stay the same.
I'm no hero,
but I'll never let you down.
I'll always see you
long as time around.
I'll always see you for the beauty that you are.
No, I'm no hero, but I'm always here when you call.
A little rough around the edges. Got my baggage, I've been telling, see the scars. But I know one thing's for certain, I would bleed for you. And if you ask me for my heart, you know it's yours, you know.
I can listen, I'll be humble, I can learn from you. You can trust me, I've been loyal, I won't change.
I won't change.
Whoa, you're my reason, you're my passion, you inspire me. Always be the one that you can count on, the one you know stay the same.
I'm no hero,
but I'll never let you down.
I'll always see you
long as I'm around.
I'll always see you
for the beauty that you are.
No, I'm no hero,
but I'm always.
Once again, you can follow us everywhere. This is all our original music that you're listening to tonight. We've got Spotify, Apple Music, YouTube, all the streaming platforms. Dom and Jesse, DomAndJesse.
Yeah. So ladies and gentlemen, this is Dominic Tursey right here to my right. And he's got...
Thank you.
He's got a special talent he'd like to show you.
Not that one.
No, not that one.
Not that one.
Don't, no. Don't even do that here.
We're family friendly here.
I'm talking about Dominic plays a right-handed guitar, upside down, left-handed. And to demonstrate that, we're going to switch guitars right now. Dom, you ready? Let me get that. I never get to play Dom's guitar. This is great.
I never get to play Jesse's guitar.
Hey, this next one's called Won't Waste My Time. And big shout out to our team, crew, the ring. Big shout out to y'all. Thank you guys for coming out for us. We love you guys. Thank you so much. This music wouldn't be the music it is without you guys.
Yes,
and that's
sir.
For sure.
Thank you guys for pulling up. You should play my guitar more often.
I didn't have all that, more than I could ever need. It used to be all bad, the coldest joke you've ever seen. But now I'm almost bad. You took a chance on me, now you can love me. Baby, you got what I need. Been working for you, yeah, you.
Time not for wasting, my hands on your waist, ain't no time for waiting. More than a woman, BG's Aaliyah. Butterflies on the inside when I see ya. Causing havoc, gotta have it, it's a habit. You can't imagine all the magic, never tragic. We classic, Chuck Taylor's leather jacket, full of Mike Jackson. Who's better? Nobody like you. Enjoying yourselves with us tonight for vibing out. Big shout out to all the other artists here today. It takes a lot to come up here and perform your own song, so much respect to each and every one of you. Let's have a good time. Dom, can I please have my guitar back?
I like mine better anyway. I'm sorry, but I'm a Taylor guy. I prefer Taylor over Martin. Here you go. But regardless, Taylor and Martin, yin and yang, Dom and Jesse, yin and yang, when they come together, it just works. You know what I'm saying?
This last song of ours is the story of how we came to Philadelphia. So, Dom,
hold on.
You can tell it really
quick. I just got to give a quick thanks to all the performers before us. Let's give a huge, huge round of applause to them, please. And everybody coming up after us as well. PHL Live for putting on this amazing, amazing platform for us. This is a very large, small city, and it's, you know, those of you who are from Philly, you understand how difficult it is to chase your dreams, especially from here. Yet, for some reason, we grow some of the most amazing talent in the world based out of Philly.
So, let's go. Let's hear it. That's right, Philadelphia. Come on.
With that said, you know, I was born in Florida, raised in Connecticut. I went to UArts here in Philly, and I came to Philly to pursue a dream because I knew Philly had that dream for me.
Hey, my name is Jesse. I come from West Palm Beach, Florida. Anybody here from Florida? Didn't think so. Didn't think so. Hey, maybe one person. But yeah, I mean, more important than what we do up here is why we do it and the reason we do it. And we have families we do this for. We have loved ones. We have ones we've lost.
Summer all year.
And just never forget your purpose and why we do this, why we put so much time and effort and love into what we do. You know what I mean? We have one life. We got to live it. We got to enjoy ourselves. And that's what Summer All Year is all about. This next song of ours is called If We Don't Leave Now. Amazing, Philadelphia. Thank you. We love you so much. Thank you.
Once again, we are Dom and Jesse. We appreciate y'all. Summer all year, baby.
Hey, don't you think you guys are going anywhere? I got to ask you guys a question.
I'll show you your guitar.
Hey, what do you guys think of Dom and Jesse?
Thank you.
So, obviously, you guys harmonize really well together.
Thank you, sir.
I got a question, though. I mean, obviously, you could both go off on your solo paths.
You can be part of the group right now.
I'm part of the group.
Yeah.
You can obviously go off and do your solo careers. But why would you want to stay as a duo? Give us the answer.
We stay as a duo because we're yin and yang. You know what I mean? Without yin, there's no yang. And without yang, there's no yin. And we've grown for 5 years to build a bond of brotherhood. And it's gotten to a point where, like, I understand what he's going to do before he does it. And he understands what I'm going to do before I do it. And it just, we understand that with the two of us, it creates a third mind that helps hopefully one day change the culture and really make a difference to this world. You know what I mean?
My answer is more simple. It's fun. It's just more fun.
Well, I mean, obviously you guys both are amazing.
This is why we're yin and yang, you know what I mean?
The yin and yang has to go back and forth. So basically you finish each other's sentences, what you're saying.
Yeah.
All right, and one other question I have for you guys before you leave the stage. You guys were here, I saw you guys in 2019. Yeah. What made you guys come back and resubmit for PHL Live again?
They paid us. No, I'm kidding. No, we love the city. We love Philadelphia.
Yes.
It's a pleasure to be a finalist and be recognized in any way by the city. That's your question, why we came back to the PHL Live? Oh, we love it. We love, that's basically it. We love Philadelphia. We met in Philadelphia. Big shout out to Sean and Range, those who even introduced Dom and I.
Yeah.
So Philadelphia, like, when they say city of brotherly love, like, they meant it. And we got a lot of brothers and family here now in Philadelphia, so...
And once again, like, what Councilman David O is putting up tonight and all these other nights, this entire thing for PHL Live is giving a platform for these musicians that are up and coming, and it's seen by new people. Like we haven't seen half of you guys before. And now you're friends, you know what I mean? And, like, this is what this culture is about, and David O has given this platform. And with consistency, anything grows more and more. So hopefully someday this gets worldwide, and, you know, you, David, I really wish you the best and hope that you can bring this
Councilman
to
Councilman O, give him a round of applause.
Thank you, Councilman. Not only that, but Kyper, Camille, yes. Oliver, Nash.
Yes. Yes.
This night's about all of us, and we appreciate it.
Very talented people.
One more round of applause for Dom and Jesse. At this moment, I'd like to introduce one of our other judges. Let me see if he's out there. Oh, yeah, I see you. It's kind of hard up here with these bright lights. But I want to introduce award-winning producer, Mr. Mig. Come on up to the stage. Tell us who you are and what you do.
Well, Brian. Hello, World Cafe Live. This is beautiful. Another year of the experience with these amazing artists from Philadelphia once again shows that this city has what it takes to have the next big artist to put on the map. I've judged a few times so far, and it never ceases to amaze me just the wonderful talent that we have in this city. And I think that the platform that Councilman O has put together with PHL Live is amazing. It really just brings out the best of the best in the city, and I'm really honored to be part of this. Like I said, once again, for my third year. And I think I actually MC'd one year too, impromptu. I came in as a judge, and you're like, "No, you're gonna MC." I was like, "Oh crap! I hate talking in front of crowds." But here I am doing it again. So, anyway. My name is Steve Migliori. I have been in the music business for about 25 years. My name as a producer is Mr. Mig, and I kind of have an eclectic background. I am everything from a producer to a DJ, and in between as a remixer, engineer, was on one of the biggest radio shows on iHeartRadio for about 10 years called the Remix Top 30 Countdown. And which has since been retired, but it was a great experience. So, you know, that's my background. Once again, I mean, even tonight, the talent that we've had up here, we have Kyper, really cool. We've had Camille K, Dom and Jesse. I mean, between those three acts so far, the diversity of what we have in the city is amazing. And I really look forward to the next couple of acts. That's it, unless anybody wants to ask you some questions. That's pretty much all I have for you. I have 5 kids, 3 dogs, and a wife. And thank you for my award. Oh, wait, no, it's not mine.
Give it up to Mr. May. And at this point, we want to recognize our partners. We have Philadelphia Folk Song Society, 90.1 WRTI, iRadio Philly in the back there, as we said before. And That Mag, which is the thing that I have, thatmusicmag.com. We are the only music publication in Philadelphia, and we've been around for 20 years. So that's a long time. We beat everyone out. People thought they were better than us, and we're still here. And we always write about the music and about the artists in Philadelphia and the artists that are coming into Philadelphia. So if you want to listen to new music or check out new things, check out thatmusicmag.com. And I will come back when they're done breaking down. Hey, I'm just going to piggyback on everything you guys already heard before. Like, the talent in Philadelphia is amazing. You know, I left Philadelphia. I went to New York City for 9 years, and I came back because the talent here is much better. I can't tell you that. I mean, you guys all know it. That's why you're here on a Wednesday night, because the talent in Philadelphia is amazing. I'm just not going to say much more other than introduce the next artist. Is she here? Oh, here we go. So let's give a warm welcome to Naj. Naj.
Yeah, I will appreciate this one. Thank you. It's the best. What's up, y'all? My name Naj. Hey, what's up? I'm from Philly already. Listen, we about to get real, real turned up in here, all right? This is my first pop rock song, so y'all ain't got to bear with me. Just vibe out, all right? It's going to be amazing. I promise. I promise. Facts. Gotcha. I got you, B.
When will we stop? Round and round we go. Where will we end up? Wherever the wind blows. When will we stop? Round and round we go. Where will we end up? Wherever the wind blows us. That's what we both will end up. Wherever the wind blows us.
Smile.
When the sun goes down and the stars come out, you're the only one I'm thinking about. When the sun goes down and the stars come out, you're the only one I'm thinking about. When will we start round and round we go? Where will we end up? Wherever the wind blows. When will we stop round and round we go? Wherever the wind blows us, that's where we both will end up. Wherever the wind blows us, that's where we both will end up. Inside out and outside in, you got my heart to the end. Let your feelings show. You hold on back, we won't grow. Baby, go with the flow. Ooh, use a natural. Hold my hand and don't let go. I got a place that we can go. A real sight, you see. I'm talking magical. With me is where you should be. Levitating when the stars get lost in the stars. Ooh, we ain't got to go far. No, we ain't gotta go far. We could stay right where we are. I can't let this song in without telling you you're beautiful. So beautiful, hey. This song in without telling you you're beautiful, so beautiful, ayy. When will we stop? Round and round we go. Where will we end up? Wherever the wind blows. When will we stop? Round and round we go. Where will we end up? Wherever the wind blows us. That's where we blow. I can't let this song end without telling you you're beautiful. so beautiful, ain't ya? I can't let this song end without telling you you're beautiful, so beautiful, ain't ya? Yeah.
Thank y'all. That was it.
Oh, wait. We can't walk away yet. Hey. You can't walk away just yet. So what makes you want to be the next PHL Live? What?
Let me explain the song. That song came from a platonic relationship. A lot of times we get in platonic relationships and we say, we're going to keep this right here. But our heart be different from our mind. So even in our mind, we're telling ourselves we're going to keep this right here. Our heart tells us, you know what I'm saying? About 2-3 months, we somewhere else. So that's why I say we're going to go wherever the wind blows. Because in a platonic relationship, you don't really know where it's going to take you. You might want to start off as friends or buddies or whatever, but you don't really know where you're going to be at in the end. So just go wherever the wind going to blow you. That's where that song came from.
How can we find your music?
I'm all over on every platform. All y'all got to type in is N-I-J, Nige. That song right there is called Carousels, because carousels go round and round. So yeah, I'm sorry, y'all. The introduction to that song, that was called Carousel. I've been doing music for 5 years. I do 7 different genres. I just tapped into the pop rock whole thing or whatever. Camille, I want to work with you. I can't wait. I hope you say yes. whatever, but yeah, that's my pop rock. My pop rock, I do 7 different genres. Reggaeton, reggae, rap, R&B, hip hop. I just love music. So, yeah, that's me.
Yeah. So it's safe to say you wake up every day, there's no music on, you can't get to play, but you need to have that music.
Oh, yeah, listen, I wake up every day, I try to make it my goal to complete. Me, just personally, this is not no pressure on nobody else. Me, personally, I make it my goal to complete, like, at least 5 or 7 songs a day. Like writing, I try to write 5 or 7 songs a day. And it don't gotta be one genre. I might start off rapping and then the next song will be pop rock, the next song will be reggae. That's just me though. Like I'm named after a jazz person, Najee. And my mom just put the A at the end, Najee. So, yeah.
Let's give it up for Naj, everybody. So, keeping up with the flow of the night, I want to bring up our last judge, but not our least judge. Personal friend of mine, I've known for many, many years. I actually got to a partnership with this gentleman last year. We're working together for a long last time. Put your hands together for Rob Schwartz. Rob, you got to tell us who you are, what you do. You go.
I got an important question for everybody. What's the deal? So everybody's Rob Schwartz in the place to be. So yeah, man, this is my second night judging for PHL Live, man. I own a whole bank distribution. I have 1,000 artists and labels distribution. Free music TV networks. We're the first ones to put music on Roku. We did a lot with Netflix. I just got done doing a movie. I do a lot of movies, sync licensing for movies. But I just got them producing, working with the producers of a movie for When the Girls in Stranger Things. So we just wrapped that up 2 weeks ago. But we do a lot of stuff, man. I work with a lot of musicians. I've been doing this my entire life, which I love. This is my favorite thing in the world. And we have a music conference coming up in Philadelphia in February. My partner, Jim over there, and Brian, called Play Music Conference, coming up in February. We're going to be the first music conference in Philadelphia in 20 years. So we do dope stuff over here. So yeah, I've interviewed over 3,000 celebrities, have a couple TV shows, a lot of movies, and music is my life. Music television is my life, music movies is my life, but all I do is music, and I love it, and tonight's been an amazing experience. Shout out to you guys, everybody that performed tonight. You guys were amazing, man. I had a great time, and now we have one more act. So this is, it's been an awesome night, man. I'm like overly like, man, I need another drink.
Yeah, man, Rob Schwartz. Yeah, man. So anyway, thanks you guys for coming out. Thanks for giving me an incredible experience. And I want to give a special, special shout out. I know my boy Yanti left, but I want to give a special, special shout out. We do have a pop star celebrity in the house. You guys may not know, back hanging out. My man right here, Sean Rivera. I'll give a shout out to man Sean Rivera. He is a platinum recording artist, Grammy nominated artist from a group called As Yet. If you guys know Philly, it's one of the most legendary groups in Philly. So I always come around with my friends. So shout out to, especially thanks to David O and Tom and everybody else for having us here. I appreciate you guys. Thank you so much. Yeah, man.
Awesome. So we'll do the changeover, and I'll come back in a second. Oh, look at that. coming down to the end of the night. Hey, I want everyone to give a warm applause to everyone who performed this evening. Come on now. At this moment, I am proud to introduce you to Oliver Dagum.
Dagum.
Oh, I screwed it up again. I promised him I wouldn't do it, but Dagum. It's Oliver Dagum.
Yeah.
I don't know what will tomorrow bring, but as long as you believe in me, everything's gonna be alright, everything's gonna be just fine. I don't know what will tomorrow bring, but as long as you believe in me, everything's gonna be alright, everything's gonna be just fine. Don't know what tomorrow brings, I don't know what the song is.
Alright, that's not even finished. I'm looking for a rapper for that song. So that is, I know that's a hit, but you know, some people don't even realize it. I'm just working on it. I'm gonna sing you a couple of songs that I have been working on, and two songs that have awarded me, that I won from the New York Singer-Songwriters Association, and also for the Singer-Songwriter Cape. So this next song, so just a quick introduction though. I am a military veteran. I separated in 2015. It's going to be a long story a little bit. So this is my passion. And I graduated from Berkeley with a music business, summa cum laude in music business. Yesterday was my first class teaching how to collect your music royalties. So I'm trying to teach these guys how to collect their performance royalties since World Life Cafe pay ASCAP, BMI. And no one's teaching that, unfortunately. And I'm teaching this for free. I only have 2 students yesterday. So, as long as you pay for parking and give me some, parking over here is always crazy, so. But here's this next song that I basically composed it for my wife when she and I met. So hopefully you like this one. It's not scary. It's not, nothing bad about it.
Slowing down, my beating heart seems to be the only sound. Your smile sets me free. Emotion stirs as you're sitting right next to me. Sometimes when you think that you know it's on the other side of the door, comes back to surprise and show things you never felt. I really enjoyed today. It was late at night and I just can't stay. But I don't wanna leave, cause this feeling's so real as my heart is falling now. All I want is to hold you, to kiss and caress you the way that we did just now. As I look at you and say, how your eyes just melt me away. And we both are just trembling from this perfect moment. From the depth of my heart, I know we were meant for me.
Another song's not finished. So you can imagine if that was finished in the first place. So this one is actually on Spotify, and all your, I'm an independent, basically, publisher, songwriter, everything, from collecting all my royalties. The only thing I can collect right now is the mechanical royalties, which is, because of the international stuff right now going on, but that's another, for a class to learn on. So in the meantime, here's called Run Away With Me. It's from New York City that won the song.
See me out, I got some say. You and I should go and run away. Let's take a ride and go ahead, board a train. Live a life the way we wanna be. Run away with me. Run away with me. Run away with me. Baby girl, we were meant to be. 'Cause you were always there and stood by me. So leave behind your troubles and your worries. Come along, see the world with me. Run away with me. Run away with me. Oh, run away with me. Run away with me. Oh, these days are tough. The time so fast, it's hard. Slow down and let go of the past. So many people say to give up your dreams. We'll prove them wrong, so let's go and be free. Run away with me. Run away with me. I should go and run away. Let's take a ride and go ahead for the train. Live a life the way we're meant to be.
Yeah. So that was Run Away With Me. That song, I actually... Basically, I'm a subway performer from New York City. So I've been doing that for the last 5 years until COVID hit. And one time I actually was on a train and I just envisioned running away with somebody. You know, so I was like, you know, I was thinking of like for this song for a school that I was going to, Institute of Audio Research. So I'm also an audio engineer. I'm pretty much a, you know, guy with a lot of knowledge. I've been studying music, anything about music. I'm a singer myself. I've been singing since I was 9 years old. I'm 46 years old. I know I look young. I always tell people it's the rice, but people don't believe me. So full circle. I've been 25 years ago, I was in Oklahoma, and no one was there for me to teach me about the music business. So I ended up joining the military, and then I definitely owned it. I was like, you know, that's going to be... I wish there was somebody like me right now with all the knowledge that was able to, you know, teach somebody who was like me 25 years ago. So that's my goal in life right now, basically teaching a lot of kids, performers. If you're already performing, you know, basically for anywhere, you know, it, like full-time, even at part-time, you're missing out on performance royalties. That's nearly up to $2,000 a year. I only have 5 songs. I've nearly made up to $2,000. Just typing some stuff already that I would perform for. So, anyways, last song. So, this one's a friendship song. Hopefully, you enjoy this one. If I still have my one more time, I'm gonna finish up with one more song for you guys.
When I'm falling down, you lift me up, yes you do. When my heart is broken, you take me out to ease my mind. This is true. When I'm down on my luck, you reach out to lend a hand. So glad that you stuck around, cheer me up again. Ooh, ooh, wanna thank you for being there. You're my partner in crime. You're the only one that I could count on to bail me out every time. Ooh, ooh, wanna thank you for telling the truth, being honest with me. You are my sidekick, my buddy. You're the only friend I'll ever need. When tons of problems are eating me up, you were there to lend an ear and hear my frustrations. When I lost my way in the jungle, you helped bring me back civilization. You're the only one who understands. If you need someone when you lost all your pride, I got your back, don't you worry, I'll be right here standing by. Ooh, ooh, wanna thank you for being a friend. You're my partner in crime. You're the only one that I can count on to bail me out every time. Ooh, ooh, wanna thank you for telling the truth, being honest with me. You are my sidekick, my buddy. You're the only friend I'll ever need. Ooh, ooh. You're my partner in crime. You're the only one that I can count on to bail me out every time. Ooh, ooh, wanna thank you for telling the truth, being honest with me. You are my sidekick, my buddy. You're the only best friend I'll ever need. Ooh, 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 ooh,
ooh, ooh. Those who's are going to be stuck in your head for the rest of the night. So, got one more song?
Got one more?
Yeah, finish it off. Yeah, I got about 2 minutes, I think. So, all right, let's finish up the night. Hopefully you enjoy this. Once again, I'm Oliver Dagum. Hope you guys have a wonderful evening. Stay safe going home. See you guys in a moment.
When the night has come and the land is dark and the moon is the only night we'll see, no, I won't be afraid. No, I won't be afraid as long as you stand by me. Darling, darling, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Oh, stand now. Stand by me. Stand by me. If the sky looks off, should tumble and fall, and the mountains should crumble to the sea, I won't cry, I won't cry, no, I won't shed a tear, just as long as you stand by me. So darling, darling, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Oh, stand now. Stand by me, stand by me.
Thank you, guys. That's the last song. Hope you guys have a wonderful evening, and stick around over here. I'll see you guys when I took the class, right? So,
yes, sir. That's it.
Hey, let's give it up for Oliver.
Yay. Thank you.
Oliver.
Question.
Yes. So, I think I speak for all of us in the room. First off, I want to say thank you for your service.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
So, coming out of the service, you could be anywhere. You could be anyone you want to be. And knowing everything you know about the music industry, what made you stay and do what you do in the music industry?
What makes me
stay? What makes you stay? What is your passion that makes you keep staying here? What makes you tick?
When I started out a long time ago, you know, I was 9 years old, and my teacher actually was the one who, I didn't know I could sing. I thought everybody can sing. You know, I was in grade four. I remember this vividly. We were in grade four, and I was told to sing the national anthem. I went up over there, and next thing I know, apparently she pulled me aside and told me, you need to join the contest. And I didn't know better back then. I thought she would fail me if I said no. So, next thing I know, I'm on this contest, you know, I sang Greatest Love of All, Whitney Houston.
Great song. Hard to do.
Yeah, the first, there were two segments. One in the morning, one in the evening. I killed it in the morning. The applause and everything, that was addicting. That was it. That was it for me. I'm like, I gotta do this. This is freaking amazing. And then I croaked on the second on the second half, you know, and I failed miserably. But it was just that applause. That I was like, you know, I want to hear that again. The next year after that, on grade five, I actually won first runner-up. And then first year of high school, I was actually the champion. So
what you're saying is after you came out of the service, you just wanted that applause?
Well, no. it's... Music, basically, to me, it's... I have no idea, but it just... It lifts me up. It's just, every time that there was something negative happening in my life, and I'm sure pretty much all the other performers feel that way over there. It's one of the driving forces that makes you, like, feel better, regardless of what's going on in your life, you know? Music was always something that when I listen to the songs, it just takes time, but eventually you'll start loving it again, so.
So the love of music kept you in it. That's what you're saying. There you go, love of music.
Yeah.
And one more question before you leave. Uh-huh. So knowing everything you know about the music industry, what made you, sign up for PHL Live?
Well, it was available. I saw it online, and I was like, you know what? It was like, I'm from New Jersey, unfortunately. I used to go over here all the time. I know, I'm sorry. You know, I wish I lived here in the area. You know, because I didn't, so I don't have to pay the $20, you know, or the $5 thing going across the bridge all the time, you know. But otherwise, it's you guys are the only ones that offered this opportunity. So, Mr. David O, thank you very much for that, because you don't really do that over there across the bridge. I lived in right across Cherry Hill. Nothing. I have to go over here just to deal with.
Well, that's still Delaware County. Like that. It's still part of Philadelphia.
Yeah, but still, you know, so. That's why I'm trying to create my own stuff over there, but, you know, any opportunity that gets me out over here and, perform for the guys, have my songs being heard, I'll gladly do it, so that's it.
Let's give it up for Oliver!
Thank you, guys.
Another round of applause for Camille K, Kyper, Dom and Jesse, and Naj. Now, at this point of the night, I just want to thank you for, like, putting up with me all night, but I have to do the closing remarks, and I want to bring up Councilman O, so we come up here and talk to you all. Thank you all for being a great audience. Give yourself a round of applause. And again, make sure you take care of our servers and our bartenders tonight. Thank you.
All right, let's hear it for Brian Cronin, fantastic host. Thank you so much. We're getting a little late, so I'll wrap it up real quick. I just want to say that the way we do it, you know, and sometimes people groan, but this is the way we do it. We have 10 genres of music. First you submit, it's reviewed very carefully by our judges. They select 5 finalists, and then you come here to perform in front of them, just so happens with an audience. And they get to see how you are, what's going on, all of that. And they score it. And then what happens is we leave here. But on December the 20th, there will be 10 genres of music with 5 performers in each genre. That's 50 artists, bands, choirs, whatever you have, all downstairs in the incredible main stage here at World Cafe Live with all our judges, all our hosts, and everybody else. They're going to announce the 5 finalists because you're all fantastic winners. And then I wish we had more money, but we only have $1,000 for 1 of the 5. And what happens is that gets announced and there are some other prizes. But during that time, you will get to meet classical musicians and jazz musicians and hip-hop artists and drummers and guitar players and all kinds of people. And the opportunities for collaboration is tremendous. And there have been some really great collaborations. I think it is a wonderful time to be recognized. And I will say, I'm always amazed that, you know, you'll have the rocker guy who does the Grammy award-winning hip-hop stuff with the jazz guy who discovered the roots and all these people coming together. It's so very fascinating. People so very good at what they do. So I urge you to come on out, bring your family, bring your friends. It's a great time. It's so diverse, and I think it's just so wonderful about, you know, people coming together over the arts and the diversity that ultimately comes into like one thing, right? Well, with that, what we're going to do now, we're just going to ask all our artists to come up with our host and our judges, and we're going to take a big pop music picture and end the night. Thank you so much.
Thank you all.